There is a significant number of patients are suitable anatomically for the available designs of the fenestrated and branched stent grafts. Having said that, there is also a group of patients still unsuitable because of adverse anatomical features like severe neck angulation or stenosis of the branched stent grafts or the access problems.
If you look at all the options we have for patients now and you look specifically at comparing different techniques, fenestrated branch versus chimney versus hybrid versus open, we are acquiring more and more clinical data about the effectivity or the efficiency and the durability of these fenestrated and branch grafts.
The main complications that can be associated with the fenestrated and branched grafts is mainly the increased reintervention rate because of migration or because of the endoleak, and also the renal insufficiency that can be associated with the procedures, the index procedures, and increased radiation dose.
Because of this high probability of complications, a relatively high probability of complications, there needs to be a real good follow-up. Probably in the beginning, we need a baseline CT, and we need a combined effort in CT and ultrasound follow-up to make sure that we get all the information to avoid late complications.
And this, I'm sure, will be an area of the future research, because we need to follow up those patients in a less invasive and using less radiation dose by inventing new method of detecting endoleak or sac growth or increased sac pressure.
The cooperation between surgeons, vascular surgeons and radiologists, interventional vascular radiologists, in my opinion, is very important. I've been in this business now for 22 years. And I've been very lucky to cooperate 100% with the interventional radiologist. And we see big benefits because we stay in discussion every day, because we discuss all the patients, and I think the patients benefit from it.
It's not because imaging is complex, also addressing the need how to access a branch, how to access a fenestration. That requires very specific skills and training, and at its best, it's a combination of both surgical and radiological interventional expertise.
I think for me now, in the third year of IDEAS, we can say very humbly that it's a big success and that IDEAS will go on, because it attracts not only interventional radiologists but also more and more vascular surgeons. The case presentations and the case discussions are always fully attended, so to speak, so the rooms are over full and always very interesting, and we all, even us on the podium, learn from this, and I think it's also beneficial to the public.
I'm very grateful for Circe to establish the IDEAS program, because it really brings surgeons and radiologists together to work together in such a demanding and progressive field of medicine.